Dear Turkish Americans and friends of Turkey, on behalf of Federation of Turkish American Organization, the oldest 1956 and the largest Turkish American umbrella organization in the States, we are honored to be part of this rally. Before I start, I would like to thank you, Young Turks, who makes this event in reality. Today, we are here to protest Armenian diaspora and their lives. Today, we are here to remember our diplomats who were killed by Armenians' terrorist organization Asala. Today, we are here to tell the truth to the world one more time. Today, we are here to tell Armenian diaspora, stop being liar and mislead the public. We, Turkish Americans, are proud of our history. While there were many minorities in the Ottoman Empire, such as Jews, Greeks and others, while were only Armenians residing in Eastern Anatolia singled out of relocation. Genocide is the highest crime in human history. Under 1946 United Nations Convention, the authority to prosecute and proclaim genocide is reserved for International Court of Justice and the competent domestic courts of party states, not a legislative body. Armenian allegations of genocide are racist and dishonest. Armenian allegations of genocide are racist history because they ignore the Turkish debt. Armenian allegations of genocide are dishonest history because they ignore the Armenian terror, rebellions and treason. My message to the Armenian lobby: fraud, lies, relentless propaganda got you now in 97 years. Save the ever partisan media coverage in the West since before World War I. Why not try telling the truth for a change? It's high time propaganda, bullying, and aggressive censorship are replaced by information, reason, and dialogue. In addition, as Turkish American community, we are also disappointed with President Obama's statement on April 24th. Historians, not the politicians, are the experts on such these issues of historic debate. We are disappointed that the president's message doesn't address Armenian terrorism and extremism, which to date has claimed more than 70 lives, injured more than 700 citizens, caused billions of dollars in property damage around the world because of Asala. We are also disappointed President Obama's message continues to ignore the even more profound suffering of Ottoman Muslims and Jews, over 4 million of whom perished as the Ottoman Empire was torn apart, and over 1 million of whom perished in Eastern Anatolia during the Armenian Revolt. Mr. President, we Turkish Americans are expecting you to be the fair leader, not to jeopardize the Turkish-American relationship. On April 16, 2012, the Armenian Secret Army Commander Leader Vazgan Sisian declared, "The fact that French Senate recently passed bill criminalizing denial of Armenian genocide, I take as result of armed struggle of Asala." As you can see from these kind of statements, how France and Armenia are playing together for these political games. Shame on France, shame on Armenia. 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 We are proud of our history. We are proud to be Turkish American. We are proud to stand for our nation and our future. On behalf of Federation of Turkish American Associations, we strongly urge edification on the problem of Armenian extremism in all its forms, maybe the terrorism, hate crimes, hate speech, defamation of scholars, suppression of cultural expression in Turkish festivals on campuses across America, and harassment of academicians, public servants, activists who disagree with the Armenian allegation of so-called genocide. On behalf of Turkish American community, we are doing our best so that our children continue to be proud of our history under the best conditions and prepare them for the future with great confidence. I, on this meaningful day, remember Mustafa Kemal Atatürk, the founder of Republic of Turkey, and all our heroes and veterans, including our diplomats, for the sacrifice for our country. Thank you. Ne mutlu Türküm diyene. Yeah.